What about the world number one on the men's side? Novak Djokovic tonight, first match since he lifted the trophy in Australia. Since then, what's he done? He's taken a skiing vacation. He had a little training block down in San Diego. Good, John, that he's kind of slowed things down for all the tennis he's played lately?
Yeah, we're not going to mention the palace coup he orchestrated with the ATP, but no, it's been a busy few weeks for Djokovic, and yet he hasn't played a whole lot of tennis. I think it is good for him. I think, like Federer and Nadal, he's being more judicious about his schedule. Remember, he lost his first round match here last year, his first match to Taro Daniel, so not often we see Djokovic entering a tournament with virtually nothing to defend. So things are looking good for Novak.
Yeah, I think he just seems to be in a good place. He seems very calm and relaxed about, you know, his situation, his family situation, and on and off the court. A lot of that translates to your play. And so it's more important to have the energy, have your batteries recharged coming into the big swing of Indian Wells and Miami and through the rest of the summer. So I think it's a good thing.
You mentioned the palace coup, and you kind of brushed past it. But seriously, we know that Novak likes to sort of be holistically in control of his life. He's in the middle of this huge controversy about the ATP's governance. He basically led the charge to have Chris Kermode fired this week. Could that bleed over into, could it be a distraction for him?
Yeah, I mean, he's taken on this political role. I think he's to be commended for that. There's a certain authority that comes with being the number one player. But when you have a messy situation, as we have with ATP politics and the resignation of Chris Kermode, Novak played a role in that. Yeah, that could be a distraction. I mean, that's something that he is having to deal with when he's not playing tennis. Again, he signed up for this. I mean, this was the role he took on, and kudos to him for doing so. But, yeah, that's – and he's talked about this. This is something that takes up a lot of time, and yeah. I think by virtue of that, psychic energy as well.
All right. Novak also played a little doubles yesterday with Fabio Fognini. We'll show you that highlight later in the show.